Rina Shah is a political advisor, commentator, and founder of Republican Women for Biden. I asked her for her reaction to Joe Biden picking Kamala Harris as his running mate.
A lot has been made of this pick, and certainly coming out early on and saying that it would be a woman was very exciting to many women out there. For me, I had sort of hoped that he would just say, I'd be picking a very qualified person to be by my side and really be my partner in this very, very important run for the White House. Look, I believe that if he had just picked, said that I'm getting the most qualified person and he picked a woman, it might have been a little bit more impactful, but this is really great nonetheless. And I think more than anything, I am looking as a lifelong Republican, and I know a lot of my peers are as well, at more the substance and the style this time around. But with Biden this time around, it's so important to get to the hearts and minds of potentially undecided and independent voters, which it is every election, right? It is about talking to them about how he's not going to bring a very liberal leftist agenda to the White House and how he and Kamala Harris are going to be moderates when they govern and win and govern.
So I assume as a lifelong Republican, you're more pleased that he picked someone closer to the center, albeit to the left of center, especially if he's anointing her as a successor possibly to him. But what sort of policy impact do you think she might bring to the Biden administration?
Well, certainly she does strike somebody at face value as a liberal Democrat from California, the largest state in the U.S. Senate. And I think her experience brings so much comfort to those of us who have felt that this White House has been marked by chaos and inability of how to pull the levers of government once one receives power. And we've given Donald Trump enough time to prove himself.
Rina, Nancy Pelosi, the House Speaker, has said she may call lawmakers on break back to Washington to address the Trump administration's actions threatening the U.S. Postal Service and possibly mail-in ballots. How serious of a threat do you think this is, and if so, what needs to be done?
Well, when the President of the United States admits to essentially committing an illegal act, what he doesn't realize is that this is an illogical strategy. This is absolutely does not make sense for people in rural areas like the one I grew up in, southern West Virginia. Rural people basically depend on this basic service. The USPS is a lifeline for folks in those communities. And so he actually might be leaving out a great number of his very strong base of supporters. A shrinking base at that, but a strong base. And they are in rural America. And I don't think the president quite understands the impact of his words and what he's trying to do.